Hello everyone out there on the internet, I'm Jack of All Trades, and I have a story to tell. I wanted to talk about this in my breakdown of Attack on Titan Season 1, but this information is being actively suppressed by the military police. This is a story that a surprising number of Attack on Titan fans aren't familiar with, so I intend to go over it with you. In the final episode of Attack on Titan Season 1, the ad break cards, the cards that flash on screen for the ad break in the middle of the episode, is just a massive block of text. A lot of people don't go back to revisit this. So I intend to, I'm gonna just read this as translated by the Attack on Titan wiki. Hopefully, if you're not an Attack on Titan fan and you're watching this, this story will have piqued your interest enough. You've heard of the series before, oh, is that just fighting titans, blood, battle, action stuff. But this hints at the larger mystery of the series, and hopefully if this has you interested, you will go check out the show. The final season is starting in December. You're running out of time to watch it live. One swelteringly hot night in the year 784, a lone miner attempted to pass through Walsina by going under it. A few days earlier, he stood digging in the mines, shovel in hand. A thought suddenly came to him. Maybe I could have a better life if I go to Walsina. It was almost a revelation of sorts. For days after that, the miner walked, until he found a spot in a dense forest along the wall where he could begin digging. No one would pass it, and the thick foliage overhead would obscure the watchful eyes of the soldiers standing atop the wall. Knowing this, he decided to begin his operation the following night. He dug into the ground with a wide shovel he had come to know so well, and made steady progress. Before long, the hole was so deep his entire body fit inside. When he could no longer toss the dirt outside the hole, he began shoveling it into bags. He later disposed of them by climbing a ladder. Every once in a while, he would drink water, but he would only stop digging if he needed to, like when his muscles were tightening up. The miner had absolute confidence in his ability to dig holes. That's what he had done for 20 years straight. During that time, he had learned to dig deeper, faster, and more efficiently than any of his peers. He could dig a path in no time, through difficult tunnels that gave any other miners fits. But something felt different that day. He dug and dug and seemed to make no progress. Every time he made an attempt to dig horizontally, his shovel was rejected by the earth. The wall's foundation seemed to jut deep into the ground, preventing the miner from proceeding. Still, he did not give up. He had to enter Walsina, no matter what. Life in Walsina was no longer his objective. It was meaningless to him. All that matters was overcoming this wall. The miner made a promise to himself as he wiped the ever-flowing sweat from his brow. "I'll stake my 20 years of digging on this. I will get past this wall." The hole had grown to 4 or 5 times the miner's own height when the shovel hit a hard floor of rock. It seemed to be the same material as the wall's foundation. Using all of his strength, the miner plunged his shovel into the bedrock. He failed to so much as scratch it, but his shovel broke from the impact. The miner let out a heaving sigh deeper than any hole he'd dug in those 20 years. "A wall?" the miner's friend asked, somewhat dubiously. "Isn't it strange," he replied, before helping himself to a drink. "Why would there be a wall in the middle of the ground?" The two sat around a table deep in the back of a tavern located within the outskirts of his town. The man was the miner's only friend, and the two would often drink there after work. As always, no one had invited him to drink after work that day, so he had gone to his usual tavern to tell his friend about what had happened that night. Surely the friend would never tell anyone, he thought. "What if we are not only surrounded by walls on every side, but there's a wall below us as well?" the miner asked. "So what are the walls anyway?" he continued, until his friend cut him off with a cough and looked around the tavern. The other customers were busy drinking, trying to sweet-talk the tavern lady and hollering at one another. No one was looking in the pair's direction. Still, the interruption was enough to make the miner stop discussing the wall. If someone else had so much as heard them, it wouldn't be long until the military police showed up. "Oh, it's nothing to worry about," said the friend, gathering himself. "Just keep on living here as you've done until now. You'll still be poor, but you'll have work and drink. That's enough, isn't it?" "Yeah," the miner replied. "You're right. I'll go back to honest digging. It's probably what I'm cut out to do after all." But the miner did not show up to work the next day. Nor was he there the following day. Or the day after that. The miner's friend visited his home a number of times, but he was never there. As he had no close family or spouse, no one knew where he could possibly be. The friend was at a loss for what to do, and he decided to tell the garrison regiment everything, including the details of the miner's efforts. A joint investigation was launched between the garrison regiment and the military police the next day. It seemed a bit extensive. The miner may have committed a crime for attempting to dig past the wall, but he was just an impoverished lone miner. The miner's friend could not understand why they went to such efforts. But ultimately, the miner was never found, and neither was the hole he'd supposedly dug. Not only that, the miner's friend suddenly disappeared one day, and has never been found since. This is the story of a man seeking a better life, just wanted to go to the next wall in, just to the next lair, to live a better life. And being a miner, he used his expertise in digging. So he found a wooded area beside Walsina, where no one would see him, and dug down. He dug 5 times his own height down. The whole time trying to dig through under the wall, but he just kept hitting more wall the deeper down he went. Until eventually, he hit wall below him. Huh. If you've not seen Attack on Titan, leave now. I'm going to be talking spoilers. Okay, we're good? Cool. The walls are made of titans. There are titans within the walls. It is hardened titan skin. There are walls underneath the walls. The walled human civilization, everything within Wall Maria, has a wall beneath it. We're told in Season 3, Part 2, that the king threatened that if Marley attacked, he would unleash the titans within the walls and they'd trample humanity across the earth. A fair threat. The walls are huge, there are tons of titans. What if there are titans composing the walls beneath the ground? Think how big a surface area is covered. Think how many titans that is. That is hundreds of thousands. If the king ever unleashed this threat, it would be catastrophic. Just the titans within the walls, that is the nuclear deterrent in this world. I will unleash this, knowing that there may be more beneath. That is world-ending. Think about the people within the walls, their houses, everything built within the walls. If the ones below were to be awakened, it would destroy everything. Human civilization within the walls would be wiped out overnight. I think I've said too much. My video breaking down Season 2 will be coming out soon. Good luck.